Dear students, how are you all? Hope you all are staying home and staying safe. Okay, so we will start with our today's class with the topic computer and its historical development. Okay, so in this chapter you will see the history of computer, generations of computer and characteristics of computer in this video. This is the part one of this chapter. Okay, so first we will see, okay, what is the history of computer? You all know what is the history of computer. So why we started with? We started with Stone Age. Okay, so how people were calculating that time? Okay, you all know history is the mother of invention. The same is true for computers also. History of computer starts with the necessity of the early settled man to keep count of his belongings, especially cattle. Soon he started developing a counting number system and perhaps started using pebbles for counting. So how they will use to count? You know, ever imagined they used to draw lines on the stones, or they used stones or pebbles or sticks to count those belongings, all these things. So one by one they started thinking and developing their calculating ability. Okay. Started developing automatic calculating devices. Okay, then it lead to the creation of modern computers today. So modern computers is a result of several years of hard work, remarkable inventions and useful discoveries by a large number of individuals and organizations from all over the world. Okay, so this is the brief history of computing. So man started developing counting devices, calculating devices. So it leads to a modern computer today. Okay, so now first we will see abacus. It is a counting device. Okay, these are the history of computers. What is the first computing device? Started with abacus. It is a counting device made of wooden frames and beads. It was developed by Chinese people in 3000 BC. Okay, hope you would have, still now we are using abacus for calculating, right? People have learned abacus calculating using abacus nowadays also. Next comes Napier Bones. It was developed in 1617 AD. Who developed it? John Napier. He is a Scottish mathematician. So what is that Napier Bones? It is a manual calculating device. Then Pascaline. It was developed by Blaise Pascal. He is a French mathematician. It was developed in 1642 AD. It is a mechanical calculating device used for addition and subtraction. Next comes step reckoner. It was developed in 1671 AD. Who developed it? Gottfried von Leibniz. Is a German mathematician. It is a machine that could multiply and divide. Next comes punch cards. It was developed in 1801 AD. Who developed it? Joseph Marie Jacquard. He is a French weaver. It is a punched card in looms. Okay, then difference engine and analytical engine. It was developed by Charles Babbage. He is an English mathematician. Who is he? He is a father of computer. So why he is called as father of computer? This is difference engine and analytical engine is the base for the present modern computer. That's why he is called as father of computer. He started developing difference engine. And then it came into 1822 AD, and he finally could find only till analytical engine in 1833. Okay, next one is programming language ADA. This was the first programming language. It was developed in 1887 AD. Who developed this? Lady Ada Lovelace. Okay, so she created the first programming language. So after that, the programming language was named by her name. He is the first programmer. She is the English mathematician and writer. Okay, so the programming language named after her as Ada. Next comes tabulating machine. It is a forerunner of IBM in USA. IBM is what? It's a company. Okay, International Business Machine. Okay, it was developed in 1887 AD. Developed by Herman Hollerith, American statistician. Okay, next. Mark I computer. It is the first electromechanical computer developed by Howard H. Aiken. He is an American mathematician in 1943 AD. It was developed. Next is concept of programmability. It was invented in 1945 AD by John von Neumann. He is an American mathematician. Next comes ENIAC, EDVAC and UNIVAC. Okay, so these are all the next computers developed after Mark I computer. Okay, it was developed by a group of people like Mark Marchley and Eckert and others. So ENIAC is the first electronic general purpose computer. EDVAC is the first stored program computer. UNIVAC is the first commercial computer. Can you see this computer sizes? It is the first one. ENIAC and EDVAC, they are in the big building. Okay, they are stored in a big room. Okay, and UNIVAC is slightly smaller than the other two computers. So ENIAC is electronic numeric integrated automatic computer. EDVAC is in electronic discrete variable automatic computer. UNIVAC is universal automatic computer. Okay, so next comes generations of computer. So like humans, we have generations, right? Development of computers also took place in distinct phases called generations. So each generation of computers is characterized by the use of a specific technology. Okay, so this, from this I will show you the generations of computers, its features and the components used. When it started from 1942 till present. Okay, now see, one by one we will see. First generation, there are five generations of computer. We are presently in fifth generation of computer. So first generation computer started from 1942 to 1955, it was present. So what are the features of it? It was big in size, slow in operation and consumed lot of electricity. And it is error prone too. So what are the components used in this type? It was vacuum tube. This is the vacuum tube which was used as the technology in the first generation of computer. The next generation is the second generation of computers. It is from 1955 to 1964. So what are the features of these computers? They are smaller, faster and cheaper than the first generation of computers. It consumed less power than the previous generation of computer. So what are the components used or technology used in this? They are transistors. Okay children. Next, third generation computers. They are from 1964 to 1975. What are the features of computers? Smaller, faster and cheaper than the previous generations of computers. So it consumed still less power than the previous generations. Several transistors integrated on a single chip. What are the components used? Integrated circuits, that is ICs. So you may wonder why all these vacuum tubes and ICs and transistors will remain. They will be remain in the system unit, that is CPU. Okay. So now next is fourth generation computers from 1975 to 1989. What are the features of these computers? Smaller, faster, cheaper than the previous three generations of computer. It consumed less power. Thousands of transistors on a single chip called microprocessor. Here only this microprocessor came into existence. This is a small chip will be present inside your CPU, that is system unit, central processing unit. Okay, this is a small unit present inside your CPU. Okay, CPU is a cabinet, it's a system unit. It consists of all these things. What are the things available in the CPU? You have hard disk drive, you have floppy disk drive, you have CD drive, you have motherboard, you have RAM. So many things are placed. It's like a cabin. Okay, which is making your computer work? Microprocessors. There is a single chip present inside your CPU. So what is that? What type of chip used in this particular generation, fourth generation of computers? Large scale integrated circuits and very large scale integrated circuits. We see LSI, VLSI. Okay, so next one is fifth generation of computer we are presently in. Okay, from 1989 till present. So it is extremely fast, very small and much cheaper than the previous generations of computer. It consumes very little power. Millions of transistors packed on a single chip. So what are the components used here? Ultra scale large integrated circuits. This ULSI, this is also a microprocessor present inside your CPU. So where we are now? We are in present generation, fifth generation of computers. So what is the next generation of computers? That is artificial intelligence. That is the sixth generation of computers. You will get artificial intelligence. So now we don't have artificial intelligence. Computers work only with our instructions. Otherwise, it doesn't have any meaning. It will not work at all. If you switch on the computer and sit in front of it, nothing will work. Only if you give the instructions, it will work. So what is the next generation? What is going to happen in our next generation of computers? They're going to find the artificial intelligence. They're going to find out the intelligence which can be artificially placed on the machine. You may wonder, even robo has the artificial intelligence. Yes. Everything is happening, robo, microwave ovens, and whichever box, automatically it has you may think that has artificial intelligence. No, that doesn't have. Only if you set the timings in microwave ovens, if you set this timings in the washing machine, only then it will work. Okay, so even robot, you have to give the instructions to the robo, then it will work. But in future, you're going to find out the artificial intelligence. Okay, now let's see the characteristics of a computer. So you, as a human, you may have some of the characteristics. So what are the characteristics of a computer? Can you tell me what are the characteristics? As you may think, it works very fast. It works automatically. And it will not get tired. It will store a lot of information. The information stored in that are very accurate. Okay, it has versatility. What is that versatility means? Even small calculations it will do, other big calculations also it can do. It will have a highly scientific approach also, right? Let's see the characteristics one by one. First one, what I said, speed. Just as you measure the speed of a moving vehicle, you can also measure the speed of a computer. Right. Next one is, how will you measure the speed of a computer? So based on its capacity, okay, based on the RAM, motherboard, okay, based on the microprocessors, you can measure the speed of a computer. Okay, next is automatic. So a computer is capable of functioning automatically once the process has been initiated. This is what I mentioned. Once if you initiate something, it will work automatically. Will function automatically. Next comes diligence. Man gets tired, but the computer can continue to operate at almost the same level of speed and accuracy. If you are sitting in the school from 8 to 2, okay, morning you'll have first period, you'll be fresh, and till first 2-3 periods you'll be fresh. After the break, slightly you'll get tired. Okay, by 2 o'clock you'll be, no charge will left with you. Okay, if somebody is asking you to sit for 12 hours in a school and work, write, read, will you be able to do? You cannot. You cannot do it with the same accuracy and speed. Same accuracy and speed which you follow in the first 3 periods, first 4 periods will not be able to follow it in the, you will not be able to follow the same in your next 4 periods in your classroom, right? But computer will work in the same level of speed and accuracy. It carries out the complex tasks, and also it will not get tired at all. Next comes scientific approach. The entire approach to solve a problem by computers is highly scientific and based on algorithms and mathematical logics. So what do you mean by this versatility? As I told you already, even the small calculation, simple mathematical calculation to solving highly complex problems can also be solved by the computer. Okay, that's why we call it as versatility. Next comes storage. So we'll come to the storage now. Okay, so if you're coming to school, teachers are telling so many things. Every class they are taking new lessons. Then the next day it will get continued. So is it possible for you to remember everything in your brain? If they tell you this question, you remember. Without marking anything, without just explaining, remember the question, next day you come and write the test. Can you write it? You cannot. You have to store it somewhere. Okay. And you have to read it again and place it in your brain. So man cannot remember or store large amount of information in his brain. But the computer is capable of storing an enormous amount of information permanently on various secondary media, such as hard disk, flash drive, flash drives, CD drives. Okay. In all its storage devices, once it is stored, it will store permanently. It will never get erased. So that's the storage of computer. Next comes accuracy. Computers work at 99.9% accuracy. We cannot say 100%, but 99.9% accuracy. Why? You have to initiate your work. If any mistake is in your initiation, then the computer is not responsible for its accuracy. Okay, children, hope you are clear with this. Next class, we will see continuation of this chapter, like types of computers, software, what is software, and what are the categories of software and hardware, what are the examples of hardware, inputs and output devices, okay, what are the storage devices. So there are two categories of storage devices, primary storage devices and secondary storage devices. Okay, what is the difference between these two, and the hierarchy of memory, all this we will learn in the next video. Okay, so till now you just see the video and get an idea of history of computers, generations of computer and characteristics of a computer. Thank you. We'll see you in the next video.